charity covers a multitude of sins. These words are from the epistle appointed for this Sunday. And St. Peter, when he wrote them, he meant that a man who gets his heart full of charity is sure to be truly penitent for his sins, no matter how many they may have been, and will win the mercy of God and receive full pardon for all of them. Now, I am afraid that some of you might think that giving a few dollars to the poor, which we call charity, that by doing that is a convenient way of throwing a cloak over a multitude of sins, covering them up, as it were, and hiding them rather than getting rid of them. Sacred Scripture says that almsgiving redeems the soul from death and tells the sinner to redeem his sins with alms and his iniquities with works of mercy to the poor. But the Catholic doctrine is that charity must move the almsgiving in order to work the miracle of forgiveness. It is not the money or the clothing or the food given to those who need it which compounds for sins and buys pardon at a cheap rate, but the virtue of divine charity. Christ-like love of God and of our neighbors. That's the only thing that wipes out the judgment of condemnation and cleanses the guilty stains from the soul. The giving of alms to the suffering poor is certainly one of the first things that the sinner who is trying to get back or has already got back the love of God, that's the first thing he will set himself to do. And it is the very sacrifice of his goods for God's sake and for God's love that proves that he wants to have done with his sins and that he is anxious to do penance for them. However, it would be the greatest folly in the world for a man to give alms for his sins if he was not trying to do so for the love of God. It is so very well and very benevolent to help the poor, because we don't want to see people suffering. But the thing is that thieves, adulterers, drunkards, and all kinds of sinners can do that without charity in the heart. And they think that by doing that without charity, they are very well content to have their benevolence accounted as a set off to their sins. Mere benevolence is not charity. And to think it is would be a great mistake. St. Paul says that a man may distribute everything he has to the poor and yet not have charity. So if you want your almsgiving to be profitable to your own soul as well as helpful to your suffering neighbor, the first thing we need to do is to quit sinning and begin to be, first of all, a little generous with God. Give him what he has been constantly knocking at the door and begging for, and that would be your heart, your love, your complete devotion to him. If you do that, then you will have the charity that covers a multitude of sins, even before you give a cent to the poor. Get into the love of God, and then the love of your neighbor, for God's sake, will follow of itself. You will then feed and clothe and comfort the poor, not only because you pity them, but because you love them. Then God will love you and forgive you your sins. That's how the thing works. It doesn't work in any other way. So now that we have a clear understanding of the virtue of charity, there are many ways for us to exercise that virtue other than almsgiving. For example, you will easily forgive your neighbor his offenses against you. You will hold no spite or revenge in your heart. If he has disgraced himself, you will not go and tell everybody else about it, but will jealously hide it and excuse it and help him out of his trouble. Thus, the charity you have will not only cover a multitude of your own sins, but a multitude of your neighbor's sins as well. See, but we never think that way when it comes to being charitable to somebody else in this regard. So when you forgive in charity, you will forgive out and out, as God does, and hold no grudges afterwards. Let us try then to learn this lesson and lay it to heart. Strive after this divine love. Pray for it. Ask our Blessed Lady and all the saints to help you obtain it, because your salvation depends on it. And I could say this 1,000 times, that your salvation depends on you having this type of charity. Charity covers a multitude of sins. But nothing else will cover even one sin. Nothing else. Because without the love of God, there is no contrition, and without contrition, there is no absolution. And without absolution, you're lost. Let us think about this.